what's everyone's motive, what they all are.
Jay and James spoke to T in person.
Oh. Okay, where are they?
Okay. Oh, Jay's about as well. So you, okay. Yeah, well, me and Sparky will come meet you and you can catch us up, okay? Meet us observatories. And then we'll come meet you there.
Juicy. No way the guy's been offline grinding again.
Pulled up to end the race with a gun.
Wait, say what?
He pulled up to the end of the race with a gun.
He pulled up on them with a gun?
Yeah, to the end of a race with a gun.
Why?
I don't know. I was about.
Matt. I'll try to call him in a bit.
How many food that man needs before we had that?
Yeah. Blubby. He fully is addicted at this point, you're right. Well, well, well. Realistically, yeah. If I didn't take a roleplay risk, it wouldn't have been as exciting. Though I'm glad I did.
Where's the observatory? I can go this way.
It's me time.
I made the right decision. Because realistically, I could have just done what I feel like a lot of the time happens, which is just people make the safe choice. And they don't go for what's going to lead to the best RP. But I made a very good choice in RP.
Morning. You're like, oh, it would be so funny if we got me. Wouldn't it be so funny? Anyways. And then now you don't want to do a proper wedding. You want me to do a proper engagement. You don't even want to ask me in the mirror yet.
All right, rough God.
I'm a killer bit of music.
No, we talk about... Please, please. Actually, don't leave. Don't leave.
I dare you not.
What are you lot doing here?
I'm trying to get a TLDR.
How did you not know we were here?
You was just here?
I picked the location. Yeah, bro.
Oh, me and Saint were just chilling here. We're not on the radio.
Saint, you got sniped, mate.
Wait,
are you on the radio?
No, these have come from a meeting and we were just chilling here.
No, I'm...
Yeah, Saint,
wait, I didn't hear anything on the radio until Patar said, hey.
So no, we didn't say anything on the radio. Matt called me.
No.
I said,
no one, we're acting
all surprised, but realistically, Mandem have like 5 meeting spots and they're all the same every time. So it's not that much of a coincidence.
To Jay.
Yeah. Oh, shit, we can give you some space if that's the case.
No, I've told you.
He wants me to do it properly.
Because the thing is, she was just like, yeah, we're getting married. I was like, all right. Well, we ain't even proposed though. She was like, oh, we're just gonna do it now then. She's just gonna do it. I was like, no, like, I wanna ask.
Exactly.
Should we call James and Matar here?
Yeah, I don't know if
Matar's awake. You remind me of those people who don't wanna go to Cheesecake Factory on the first date.
Right, Saint, relax. All right, I want to go Cheesecake Factory, but okay, can we talk about this later? We have, please. What's his name? Fucking Jim. On the phone.
Molding.
Yeah.
Mr. Jimothy.
Jimothy Molding. Jim Molding. He's balding. He's olding.
You have to get married because of Tommy Cruiser as well.
Wait, what? Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Did he say that? Was that his request?
It was his death wish.
His death wish was for you guys to get married.
Yeah.
He went around like a line. You were there, bro. And like, yeah.
Yeah, I know, but that did last a very long time.
It's when you got shot in the head.
Yes, that's why.
Wait, who got shot in the head?
I did, by a ghost.
I think I went. Oh, yeah.
Ghost of the Christmas. Ghost of the Christmas teatings, but you know.
Anyone want a banana on the way? Yeah, I could. No, I'm good, thank you.
A banana a day keeps the apples and the doctor away.
Why would the apples?
You don't want to mess with the apples, mate. They are different level.
That does remind me.
You've just been Snow White'd, mate.
Starving.
See you in about 8 hours when it wears off.
Snow White'd. That sounds like a. Wait, what? What does that? Wait, what's
that?
Snow
was actually
White'd?
An edible banana. It had edibles mixed in.
Wait, why is it Snow White though?
Doesn't she get poisoned by an apple? Or have I got the story wrong?
What?
I swear Snow White gets poisoned by an apple.
That's Sleeping Beauty.
What? No, I swear that's Snow White.
I swear Snow White is the one with the dwarves, isn't it? Why is that funny, Saint?
Nothing.
Nothing funny about
she does. The witch gives her an apple. And she eats it, and then it's poisoned.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I know my Snow White trivia. Don't chat to man about the dwarves.
It's good boys.
Yeah.
How the hell did you guys get here so fast?
Never mind. It's just a long story.
Yeah, we're here already. It was a meeting point, and they were here already somehow. Completely unrelated.
Yeah, we were getting married.
Oh,
and
okay.
I pulled up and they were like, why are you here? And I was...
they made a live action Snow White.
Yeah.
This is what I said, bro.
Yeah, but I haven't engaged to him.
Why did everyone remember this? Apart from me.
Everyone Gucci?
I just remember, guys.
You weren't there for the will reading. No.
You're right, I wasn't.
That wasn't
oh, no,
in
but
the will
it wasn't,
reading,
it wasn't in the will. No, he said it at the Lions.
He did leave money for Toddy and Matt to get married.
Yeah, but I can't get married before
you. Which kind of crazy
because
he didn't leave money for us to get married.
That's crazy. I reckon you guys should all chip in and pay for a marriage.
You got shares to fucking tuner shop. You can
fucking 25k. I need to cash them in. Can I sell them to fucking cash converters?
yeah, we just got to claim them off Mary Mushkin.
All right, well, which is never then.
Basically, we're silent investors.
If you actually wanted to, but I don't know.
She definitely would if she was around.
I personally, if it was me, I'd keep the shares, bro, because you have a steady flow of money from it. Then, you know?
Yeah. And you have a say in the tuning shop too, whatever it's called now, Procyon.
I think you're missing the point of, we actually need to speak to her to get the shares.
Yeah.
Therefore, currently we have square root of...
Is she not around?
Zero.
Very rarely.
No, I think she was there for Cruiser's death and then that's it.
Okay, because I gotta give her a dongle.
Should have mentioned it there then.
Oh, yeah, wow. I gotta give it a dongle. Cruiser enough to give her.
Maybe we can mention it at a funeral, but they might be a little bit insensitive.
Yeah, oh, I miss you, Cruiser. So about them shares. Oh, would be a tad, wouldn't it? When do you even bring that up? You have to wait a couple of weeks, don't you? I feel like it's something.
It's been long enough.
It's one of the it's one of those things where you have to stumble across it in conversation. Oh, so as prolapse getting on or whatever it's called, and
also, one thing to update you, team texted me last night. He pretty much said we took the easy route out and shot and robbed him. But that's
waiting on James to have a full conversation, aren't we? Is he calling him? Let me ring him again.
James,
he's ringing.
Nearly there.
Overwhelm Jim, where you at, mate?
I'm gonna call
him
tonight.
Really excited for this story.
Okay, you could. All right, hurry up then.
Well, he knows you want to speak.
Okay, good.
Good. Did you guys see him today?
Yeah, they met him in real life, right? Rather than on the phone. Why?
Okay.
Why can I not say real life without you, man, being like, because this is real life, bro. If anything, what I said was valid as hell.
Yeah, valid.
It weren't even like that.
Come on.
Just the way you said it, it's like.
Yeah, who's.
Yeah, but that's like me getting a phone call, and being like, you're chatting bears on the phone, but you're not going to say shit in real life. It's the same thing.
I wouldn't use that term over the phone. That's more like, Xbox 360 terminology, to be honest. But I get what you're saying.
Come fuck me in real life. Nah.
So you saw him in person, So what kicked off?
Wait for James.
Oh, wait for James, yeah.
It's such a cliffhanger.
Yeah, man.
I'll hang you off a cliff by the pubic hairs on your chin.
What
and
the
then
fuck?
They won't support your weight because there's so very few of them.
Oh my god.
And then you'll fall off a cliff. And then I'll come collect you at the bottom of the cliff, take you to A&E and go, this is why you should grow a fucking beard, Matt.
Oh. I was so planned out.
Sorry.
I was really...
You had that in you for a while.
He's had this plot, bro. At least we know how Matt's going to go.
You know what? Believe it or not, that actually was off the dome, but I even shocked myself.
Oh, where's
Jamaz! Okay, he's smoking, so he can't drive.
Do you know why he's late?
Why?
Mm-hmm. Repairing his car.
Deadwood, isn't it?
Broken again?
Yeah.
Matt doing a race without trying to
over
repair
here
his car
faster,
after
please.
Every crash challenge starting now. Impossible.
Oh, why are you walking in
the moonwalking?
What is
bro,
that?
Bro, are you alright?
Hey guys.
Matt's coming in with the confidence.
Did you slip on a patch of ice over there?
Okay. So, if you check the racing app, if you have a dongle, you'll see the Apex race that I hosted. It was me, Saint, and Bruno.
Mm-hmm.
And just as we were about
That's
to start...
Your fault. Stupid dongle name, Steve, it's bait.
I'm not hiding, am I? I'm not a bitch. Babyface joined and typed in chat, well. And then left. And then halfway through the race texted me saying, I'll see you at the finish line.
Hmm.
And I was like, he's just trying to spook us out. He's not going to do shit. He's not going to pull up to the fucking race. He was there with a gun.
DG, David, for the gifted.
He basically wanted to give his side of the story. So he's under the impression
Agnio
that he's
with
now
the
old,
five.
Like, in the region of 40 million.
Is that including what we've spent on wars?
Yes.
And then the gold on top and everything?
Yesterday he realized the gold.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
And he is not happy about it. I want to fact check something. He said in the meeting before you shot him that the money that was owed to him from the wars, he didn't necessarily want it back, but like he was happy for you to use that as a reason to motivate people to make money but keep it in the gang account and not actually pay him back. Is that true?
So the way he said it was, right, it was never you need to pay me back. What it was he said you could owe me 25 million, like, as it could. And then I was like, well, we don't want to go down that road. And then he played the card of, oh, well, you could. You never know what I'm going to do. You could get that money. And then I tell you, you could keep it. You know, it wasn't, he didn't say, get that money and you can keep it. It was one of the things he waved around.
Mm-hmm.
The same as the block thing, really, where he was like, I could kick you all off the block. He was listing a bunch of things he could do and waving them around. But it was not discussed as like have this really good laid out plan where you guys can accumulate 25 million and then I'll let you keep it. It was never that. Just waving it above heads, throwing it around. But I'm glad he brought it up because I forgot he said that until you just said that.
Yeah. that was pretty much it. He just gave his side of everything. His reasoning for wanting to step away. He wasn't happy about being shot. I'm sure he'll voice everything to you later when you speak to him, but he wasn't happy about being shot.
Did he seem like he'd be open to talking?
Oh, yeah, no, I asked him straight up. Yeah. What, do you want to chat to him? He said he's chat to Bear Man and he just want to chat to you.
Question where everyone's heads at with all this money back. Obviously, we've already said the gold is leverage. What the, like, the
leverage
war money?
For what, though?
The gold is leverage for us taking the gold. I don't, like, yeah, we wouldn't need the leverage if we never took the gold.
No, it's not. You could say that, but no, it's that's not true. The fact of the matter is, he got shot, right? We're never going to know what happened because Patar took the gold after that. So we don't know if he would have done what he's doing now because of the shooting anyway. The leverage of the gold was making the best out of the situation that happened and using that as leverage for the clapback. So we might have had a situation where I shot him and he's coming at us now with exactly what he's currently doing and we have absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
I will say, based on the conversation that I had with him, because I asked him these questions because we pulled up a little bit later and I started asking him some questions. And it sounded to me like he didn't like the fact that you shot him, but he understood. And if that would have been left there, that would probably be the end of it. It would be a case of whatever happens next happens, whether that be burning bridges or building bridges. You know what I mean? It would have been on pretty mutual terms. But the fact that you went as far as to like steal from him is obviously how he's viewing it. That's what seemed to have sparked this whole thing.
It's the money. So he said in that conversation that the money is the motivator for all of this.
No, I asked him. I said, "Do you want the money back?" And he said, "No." Patar already asked me that, and I said, "Yeah, but do you want the money back?" And he never actually answered. I think
yeah,
we were
same here.
Yeah, I think he kind of glazed. He kind of went on a tangent about something else.
He's not gonna sit there and say to you when we're at this point, "Oh yeah, I would have actually done something if SK shot me."
You know what the thing is? We do this every time we go on details. We always we're always justifying, like, I'm not saying we shouldn't justify this other side, but I think we're always trying to make sure I don't know how to say it, but even last time we were talking about, like, when we were going over the bench thing, we were always going after like this. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Never mind. Just
No. You're trying to say that we're always trying to nitpick at all of the small details, but what you need to understand is the reason that I do that, I can't speak on behalf of everyone, but I'm assuming it's the same fucking answer, is we want to know the full story and understand, because it's easy, as Matt just said, it's easy to say that, right? But I'm just saying that based off one side of the story, which is what T told me, or I would have been. Obviously, I know SK's side, so I can piece it together. But based on what he said, that's the story. You need to understand that the story that you guys are giving, you're leaving bits out that he mentioned, and the story that he's given, he's leaving bits out that you guys mentioned. Like, he never mentioned, like, bombing the block. He never mentioned, like, splitting up the Mandem, you know, or any of that. Yeah.
Did he mention speaking to Solomon by any chance?
No. See, he didn't mention that. And you got to remember that in these sorts of situations, everybody wants to have like the correct story, but all the stories are different.
There's two sides to every story. It's that simple.
Exactly.
That simple.
With this whole thing, right? I think he's definitely aware that there's people that don't agree with me shooting him. And I think he's also definitely aware that there's people that don't agree with the money stuff. I think, obviously, that's then going to be a go-to for him of, well, if people don't agree with the decision, I can kind of manipulate that a bit.
Well, I asked him straight up. I said, what's the motive? Like, where do we go from here? I kind of worded it a bit wrong because I said, what's the ideal situation? Which he kind of shut down the question. He said, the ideal situation's done. Because obviously we've already fucked him over. Because I wanted to know, obviously, what the motive is. And it very much, when I asked you, obviously you said, because I asked you in the car on that hill, I said, what's the next steps? And you said, well, the ball's in T's court. And then when I asked him, he didn't really say much, but I asked him who he'd spoke to because I was curious. And it's very obvious that he's basically just trying to find out everybody's opinion, and then he's going to create a divide. Mm. And once he does that, that's when people are going to start arguing from the inside.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the best way to, like, it's the smartest way to go about it, right? You find the people who don't fully agree with it, and then you try and make us implode.
It's fair to, listen, like, I know some people don't agree with him being shot. I just had a conversation with Saint, and you're more than welcome to have that opinion. But like I just said to Saint, this isn't about T being shot. I know it makes me sound like I don't care about what he's done for us, but at the end of the day, sitting around moping about it, saying, oh, we shouldn't have shot him, like, that don't do shit for us. At the end of the, you know what I mean? We're trying to do something new. SK wants to move forward with something new. It is what it is. Sorry, Appa, mate. We got to go on. Mm-hmm. It's just how it be. It's sad, but it's just how it be.
So what would we do in a theoretical world where we decided to give back the gold and he's still claiming we owe him 15 M's or what, whatever, for all the war stuff? We ain't ever paying that back. So, like...
No, we don't have to.
But in a world where we're never going to pay him back all of what he wants, and we will never be cordial because of that...
Okay, big question. Why are you paying him back?
What's the point of giving him the gold?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Are you paying him back out of respect, or are you paying him back to squash a situation? Just figure out the reasoning why you're paying him back.
To squash a situation, obviously.
See, this is the thing. That's where having the gold and stuff comes into it. Because if we didn't have anything like that, there would be no... We can't even entertain a conversation at that point, because there's nothing there. And obviously, that was not necessarily the intention at first. But once that move was made, we couldn't really backtrack. Because regardless, right? Say Patar pulled that cash out, and then we said, you know what? That's not the move. Put it back. We can't guarantee what he would have done. It's a very fucked situation, because me, just as much as everyone else, I've never wanted to fuck over the guy, right? He showed me a lot of shit, but he wanted us to move more militant and to operate better. We were leaving ourselves open to be fucked with if we didn't do something to cover our asses.
Right, well, that's my question. Why? What is the original motive from, I guess, you, Patar, to take that money? Did you anticipate after SK shooting T to clap back, so you did it as like a pre-retaliation, or did you do it because you wanted the money? Like,
so T said, Angels will never do business with the Mandem prior to this, before SK coming, etc., etc., etc. And it was more the fact of, and this is me being bluntly honest, it wasn't about the money, it wasn't about this, it wasn't about that. It was more to show he did not appreciate me, he doesn't care about me, I might as well take a bit of the pie I built for him.
So it was a personal thing, you and him, not a Mandem decision.
In a sense, yeah. Until we kept it for leverage.
Because I feel like he should know that. If it's a personal decision, I mean, well, I guess that's on USK to decide whether or not.
The thing is, I don't particularly want to just leave Patar out to dry like that. I don't think that's fair to be real. Like, is it not, like, it's not necessarily the ideal situation, but I would rather deal with that decision and claim it as ours than just leave Patar to have that decision.
Yeah, that's what I expected.
For him.
That
question.
That's fair.
Like, best situation, yeah. Where do we want to be and what do we want out of this? Like, are we wanting just to be on like neutral terms with him and call it quits, or
you got to remember, other than the block being bombed, which is obviously quite a big deal, as of now nothing has really happened. It's a lot of mental games and stuff like that, but nothing wild has happened. And I think ultimately that's what he wants, is us to be spending our time dealing with this kind of stuff.
You know the smartest thing for... The thing, T would want to break us from the inside. That's the thing. T is really good with mental warfare. He's always been a smart guy. He's very good with his words. So I feel like the more we talk to him, the more he's going to try turning each other against each other, because that's the best way to break a family is do what the men do best, argue with each other.
Yeah,
whenever we go to war, we always argue with each other. Whenever we do this, we argue with each other. And I say that hinders our performance by 50% at least.
I mean, it's fine to say that, but if we just ignore him and nobody speaks to him at all, then...
Sparky's talking to him day to day.
I know that, but you've just brought up the fact that we're speaking to him and shit and then playing into his mental warfare. What I'm saying is if we all just ignored him, what will happen is he will do other things.
We also wouldn't...
It's being aware.
Yeah, I didn't say ignore
him. I mean, look, right now, the reason we're having this conversation is because you spoke with him. It's already working. It's not about ignoring him or hating him. It's about being aware of the potential like motion that he's trying to do. Because as long as you're aware of it, you can look at things and think like, okay. You know, he said it like that. He means it like that, right? Rather than just being a bit naive to it and just going, oh, all right, yeah, I believe everything. And then all of a sudden we've got problems.
You know what Tommy told me? Is all of you guys use me. I could turn around and be like, yeah, all the men do use me and I'm out. You know, I'm talking about that. I'm not saying don't talk to the guy. At the end of the day, that's Sparky's decision. But I was just saying, it's more, he's going to most likely go for a mental warfare tactic, you know?
Yeah. He's smart of what he's doing. Even communicating, like, bringing up things that he knows we probably would have not mentioned or forgotten in the conversation. Like the whole 25 mil going to the gang account. That comes across now, at this point, as like a very big part of the conversation. But I'm not going to lie, at the time, it was very much just a passing comment. I don't know what Patar would say on that, but it wasn't like a whole discussion about how that would be a thing.
No, the thing about that conversation, it was literally Sparky making his points, T making his points, and T, whenever Sparky would make a point, he would brush Sparky's point and be like, well, it's all talk, no action. Like, that whole conversation wasn't it wasn't crazy detail, you know?
I asked you before. Go on, James. Go on, brother.
One thing that I wanted to ask, right, is when we were at this meeting, T said about, he texted you and said, you can either, like, return it up at Tar. You can either return it or there's going to be a whole world of problems, right? And instead of giving an actual response, you reply with, like, a meme or some shit. Like, I don't really get what the point of doing that was. It just seems like you're trying to antagonize him more. You know what I mean?
Let me check my phone real quick.
Apparently it was the, ooh, shiver me timbers. You know that meme?
Yeah. Let me just look at context.
That was before the block was bombed.
Yeah, and apparently that was pretty much why he bombed the block.
I didn't really get an answer.
He said,
like, what are we trying to get?
Like, well, that's what I was about to ask. I asked you a couple of days ago, SK. I said, listen, what's the motive? And you obviously gave me a little bit of a... understanding. Now I kind of know the full story. Like, what is the motive? Like, what are we trying to get from this? What are we trying to do?
There's nothing to get from it. It's moving forward and doing the steps to start fresh and level up and be the new Mandem. And if we have to deal with shit that is done to him by him, sorry, then we will. It's literally that, like,
are you trying to
it's not survive. Well, I don't, the thing is, there's no need to right now, right? Like, well, I can go to him on the phone and I can say, look, here's all the gold, here's all this, I'm gonna give it back to you, we'll go our separate ways. I could do that. If that was done, I think it's a bit too little too late.
I hear that. The problem is, if you don't do that and you tell, maybe not tell him, but we're of the opinion right now that nothing's really happening, right?
I'm trying to prolong the arc. I feel like it's getting to a point where the gang wants to give all the shit back.
Maybe they don't.
But I'm trying to prolong it as much as possible.
Cheating like that, you don't just switch gangs. I mean, he might be cool with them, he might chill with them, but I can't see, like...
Yeah, I'm with you on that.
He's been in the Mandem for multiple years. He's just left a gang. It's like... Like an ex,
it's not necessarily switching gangs though, but what's stopping him going to a gang and just saying,
you don't have a relationship and jumping another one?
He's not jumping in. I'm saying he could pay a gang to come fuck us up at any point.
All right, question is,
maybe
then
let's
not beat around the bush. Out of everyone here, who wants to give the shit back?
I think we should personally.
And feel free to voice it. Like, I'm not going to feel a way about that. Like, because ultimately,
It's about doing, like, I want to hear everyone's perspective and understand what you all want in it.
I think especially the gold needs to go back.
I was going to say,
you could argue the money, Pitar, that's fine. But the gold, even the stuff in like Denzel's stashes and shit, I think that needs to all go back. Because
he's gonna have to get storage for us, because we need room for that.
But even if we vocalize the point that you know we're willing to give it back, it's just, you know, you need somewhere to put it. And out of gesture of goodwill, we start with the dust, for example. You know, I think it's better than just holding it all, because at the end of the day, it's of no value to us.
See, that's the thing. It's kind of hard for me to prolong it when the whole gang wants something, because I can't just do something because SK wants to do it. I need to think for the whole gang.
So I think as a gesture of goodwill, we should give all of the gold back.
Again, I don't care about giving it back. It was more of the principle of seeing if the only thing he cares about is the money, or he actually still cares about us and me and the Mandem, you know?
So I don't know. He was on the ground after being shot and then got stolen from. I think it's
more the principle.
Yeah, it is. So James, what do you think? You think we should give it back as well? Yeah, that's what you're saying.
I don't know if we should, because the thing is, I think we should give the gold back, yeah. But I don't know about the money, because at the end of the day, the money's going to benefit us. And he's already said that we're past his point of ideals or whatever he said. Pretty much saying it's not really going to make a difference now anyway. So.
Do you know what we do?
We shouldn't have took it in the first place.
We try and do what Lang did with our chains. We say every week you leave us alone and you don't hurt or do anything to us, we give you X amount of gold back. Because then he's leaving us alone exactly what we want, and he's happy, because realistically, if we're fired at Gold Rush, we can't even make money from that gold, because we can't turn it into bars anyway. So,
I don't think that's the move.
That's the backwards way of doing it, I think. Because you're basically saying, oh, we'll give you a back, but we don't trust you to not do anything. So, we're only giving you.
Also, what are we paying him to stop? Like, we're still very much operating on this basis as if it's like all hell has been broken loose.
Yeah, no, you're right. We hold it until he does something.
The thing is, from a gang standpoint, we're throwing all our leverage away, but from a personal standpoint, I'm more than happy to give him the gold, you know?
Bro, that's a personal standpoint, bro. This guy is threatening us.
Realistically...
He said you're a dead man walking, bro. Like, this ain't no personal level thing. We need the leverage.
I believe we should stand on our decisions, but I'm also not going to sit here when I've got the whole group wanting to do one thing and go, oh, no, well, I'm gonna push it this way then, because I do have all your best interests, like, at heart. That's the thing, right? So if everyone genuinely wants to give it back, as much as I do think we should stand on what we've done, I will have a conversation with him. I'm not just going to disregard what you lot want. What do you think, Saint?
I think we should. I mean, it's just respecting, you know? Like, I get that, like... I don't know how to word what I want to say. I just think we should give it back.
I know you were saying he hasn't done much, right? And that's
He's
not...
He's called us.
Okay, well, he bombed the block.
Yeah, I know,
I don't know why we're acting like he couldn't just fuck us up.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like,
he has the facilities to fuck us up, like, and that's the fact. He could turn around to any gang and pay them any amount of fucking money. It could be Saints, for all we fucking know. And he could fuck... I know. Okay, he might not. That might not be the Tommy Tate way, but that is a possibility. It could happen.
Red Observatory.
I am trying to... My point of giving the goal back is more of a gesture of goodwill to preemptively stop something like that happening.
I do agree, but if we're going to apply that level of fear, right, and if it is the situation of T could get the Saints involved, then on that same mindset, why are we going to then have discussions about how we should go into a coke run six man deep, ready to do, like, if we're ready to fight them in that context, why aren't we ready to fight them in this context?
And bro, oh God, like, as well, like, when we give this gold back and he says, yeah, you owe me another 15 mil from wars, and we tell him you ain't getting it, and he does exactly the same thing as before the gold, bro. Like, please, can we? I beg we don't give him this leverage. Like, he's literally threatened to kill Pitar, said he's a dead man walking. Like,
he almost killed Ben too.
Like, there ain't no respect here, bro. Like, he'd be threatening the gang.
He almost killed Ved with his airstrike too.
I'd be vexed if we just give it back to him before he's done now. Like, yeah, he bombed the block or whatever he did there, but You know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day, it's the block. We got to defend it. And as much as you're saying he can pay these people to come shoot us, like, I know, yeah, we got rolled in the Saints war, but we weren't fighting to our strengths. And that's exactly what we need to do.
90% of us lost.
We need to defend the block.
90% of us lost their mental during the Saints fight. Like, James, you're out of it. Winston was out of it.
I mean, you can say that, Lopatar, but the reason you lost your mental is because we got smoked repeatedly. That'll happen again if we get smoked for another week straight. I guarantee it.
But the thing is, yeah, like, we were fighting them in the south side. We didn't want to fight them there. We were going for sprays. We couldn't take them because they didn't have anyone on the gang app. They weren't waking up. But if the thing is, yeah, if we're defending at our ends, bro, it's a completely different fight. It's a completely different fight. Like,
my question as well is, like, what is the... Do you believe that returning the gold leads to all issues resolved? Genuinely.
I think T is way more pettier than that.
Because I think it's pretty... I think it's pretty obvious that if you know him, it's never going to be that simple. We already... Ultimately... We have made our bed.
All right, I'm going to say this then. If we don't give anything back and it just escalates into a war, I know for a fact I'll be stood here with a gun in my hand every day. If people ain't around for it, and they after they've said, no, we ain't giving them shit back, we need the leverage, and then they don't actively fucking back it, I won't be happy.
Yeah, as you should. This is the thing. We all have to be on that same page. I'm going to call him tonight. And I'm not going to say, oh, you're getting your gold back. I'm going to feel out what's going on and where he's at. And I'm going to give him my reasoning for shooting him. Not from even from a gang thing, but to get that weight off my shoulders.
Do me the favor.
What did he say to you? Actually, question. What did he say to you about the shooting thing?
Who, me?
What, you getting shot?
When you met him, no. Me getting shot? No.
I'm be trying.
Oh, no, you shooting him.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Anyone help me here? Because I'm trying to... I'm
I mean,
to
when Jay was talking to him about it, the way Jay put it was that we get... At the end of the day, you're the leader now, so we back your decision. And he pretty much said that's fair enough. So to be honest, I really don't think he's that pissed about the shooting. I think it's very much more so the fact that the money was stolen.
Yeah,
and
it's the aftermath of
the antagonizing after the money was stolen as well.
Yeah, he wasn't happy he got shot, but at the same time, he kind of also said, like, okay, it's SK's way of, you know, proving himself or whatever is the way he put it.
He understood
the
main
thing I think the
issue what
is,
he said.
Is that happened to him. He got shot in the back of the head, lying on the ground, and then had everything stolen from underneath him. You know?
Sparky, when you speak to him, if he asks for the gold, do me the favor and ask him, like, if we gave him the gold back, is he still going to be coming after us for the rest of the money? Because that's why, like, where my head's at. If we give him the gold, who's saying this is going to end, bro? Or whatever he's planning is going to end. He's going to be still
trying to catch
us lacking.
Nothing's
going to
change. I hope you realize that.
Yeah, it literally is throwing our leverage in the ocean, bro.
I am somewhat confused, though, because why are people so scared? Like, when it comes to other wars, people aren't normally this scared.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, I know there's been a bombing at the block, but like, as of now, we've not been given a reason other than mental warfare to really be too concerned.
It's more the fact that we just got smoked by the Saints, and I think we could have easily avoided this, to be honest.
I'm going to ask you a question. Do you really think T is going to go and get the Saints?
No, we're already in it, though.
I'm not saying that that's the thing. I'm just saying I think it could have been easily avoided.
Yeah, but we're already in
Saints stuff.
No, not the Saints stuff. This. That's what I've been mainly saying.
What's happened is happened, though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've already vocally said to Sparky several times, I don't agree with the shooting and I don't agree with the gold stuff, but it doesn't change where we are.
And I've said this to everyone. I thought, like, ultimately, it doesn't matter if you agree with me or not. I don't have any animosity to anyone that disagrees with what I did. Like, I get it. Me as a person disagree with what I did, but I had to do it. That's just how it is.
Where we are right now.
And we're still in this situation, right? I get what you're saying, James. I do. Like, it could have been avoided.
But also, like, we don't even know what it is we could have avoided right now. One block bombing.
I think one other thing is, we all sat there, voted Sparky in as our leader. At the end of the day, if I agree or disagree, I'm gonna back whatever Sparky decides, you know? Because everyone had a chance to object there, and no one did.
I'll call him today and ask him a few questions. And realistically, it's kind of a good conversation because he already knows everything. So it's not like I have to pitter-pat around it. It can be a pretty straight-up conversation. And I might ask him about Solomon.
Hey, wait, you mentioned that twice now. I don't even know about Solomon. I don't think.
Steve, you want to give him the sitch?
Tell me about Stolifan. Stolifan? His brother.
Steven has picked a really bad, really, really bad time for this.
Is it from the beginning? You don't know about Solomon, or you know?
No. Last I heard of Solomon, shot in the face, coma. I said, keep an eye on him, because he might fucking be the one that told Saints, because he's suspect. Yeah.
Basically, he reemerged after the whole shooting thing on the day that Tommy went public with the stuff on Twitter and came and spoke to me, Matt, and Steve. And just kind of like, yeah, I'm back. Poked around, asked a few questions.
Yeah, I remember that.
Fast forward from there, I spoke to him on the phone. I kind of came clean with what happened just to gauge his response and see what his energy was like. He was very off of me, very cold. Like, it was clear that
Solomon,
there was like, yeah. It was clear that there was something different, like something had changed. Steve then had a meeting with him, where he basically like threw a bit of a rope and seeing if it got tugged on, where he said that he'd only really been given half the story by Patar and wasn't sure what to think of it. And Solomon had told him in that meeting that he'd spoke to T. So he was a bit concerned that, you know, they'd spoke.
He had planted some seeds already. Yeah.
And then shortly after that meeting Steve had where he left that open end, he gets a text from Tommy saying, please tell me Patar told you everything, which could be coincidence, don't get me wrong, but obviously lines up with what Steve was trying to do. So we best to not trust Solomon right now. I mean, not even best to not trust, just we are not trusting Solomon.
I never trusted
right.
that Don anyway.
It's just completely you. Like, even if he does like try to rebuild a bridge on this side or whatever, it's just too risky at this point to.
Yeah, I hear that.
To tell him anything or trust him. So that's where that's at. But I want to ask him. I want to say to T, I want to say, like, I know you spoke to Solomon, and kind of just say to him, like, I know what you're trying to do, like, and just reason and
see
what he says.
Listen, I said this in the meeting, yeah. Like, you know, SK, that even though what he's done, I don't agree with, that is obviously leaving the Mandem, like, he is a pretty reasonable guy at the end of the day. And I know a lot of people change their attitude around him, like, they kind of, I don't know, they're a bit more like yes sir no sir when he's there. But like, you know that you can just have a straight up conversation, call him out on his bullshit, and he'll tell you the truth. Like, but at the end of the day, just, and this is what I said to Saint, and I guess this is to everyone, just be aware as to what's going on. If you're talking to T, he's likely either planting seeds or gathering information. So just be aware of that.
And he's probably aware of that from us too.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's not dumb.
He'll know what we'll be like. We'll be aware of it. He's just probably going to see if it will still work.
Yeah. I mean, he's been texting all of us, right?
I get it though. Like, I want you to all know that. Like, I fully get it. Like, that man had a lot of respect from everyone. And the thing is, people's response to him was unlike a lot of other gangs and unlike a lot of anyone's responses to an individual. Like, he, I don't know if it was masses of respect or somewhat underlying fear of like losing chains and stuff, but there was you know, people operated differently around him. So I understand why people are skeptical, but we just got to trust each other.
Yeah.
Because nine times out of 10, we spend 8 hours a day together without him. And I know it's hard and it's difficult that he's not going to be a part of this journey no more, but ultimately we can continue it and we will. We can't dwell on what's happening.
You weren't in the journey. You weren't in the journey for him, you know? You're in the journey for this. Everything.
But I can't stress this enough, right? I want you to feel like you can talk to me and to anyone. Be transparent. I know sometimes it can come across with this whole situation that it's like a us versus T, but I do have understanding. I know he's contacting people and I know, like, you know, don't hesitate to just be open. I had to, like,
with him or you?
Me.
Like us.
And us, everyone, like the Mandem. Like, I had to get it out of Winston the other day, but, like, he, you know, he came clean to me. He said he reached out to him and he asked for a phone call and it was, I don't have animosity of people wanting to get his side. Makes sense.
You think it'd be a bad idea if I go meet up with him?
Yes.
Yeah.
Probably.
Jesus Christ, Patar.
And anyone that wasn't here last night, we said, please, for the love of God, no one let Patar be alone at any point. T called him and said he's a dead man walking. And
I didn't know that.
Yeah. So there's been
a meeting earlier.
There's been a threat, mate.
Yeah, he reacted. You were like, oh, really?
Wait, really? Because the thing is, I think sometimes, I don't know. I'm just listening to what he said. I mean, was that, I don't know when that was. Because obviously, you two were already there and then we just fucking pulled up. Were you about to end the meeting when we pulled up or?
Yeah.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah. Pretty. I don't know. Like, for me, it's just like what's done is done.
Is that not a Solomon? No. That's BBMC.
Like, what you know, what's done is done. Let's not get caught up on it and cry about it and fucking worry about it. With the whole gold shit and the money stuff, like, listen, he's gone now, innit? It is what it is. Like, I don't know why we're so overly scared, is the only word that I can think of, about some, like, repercussions. Like, I appreciate who he is, but I thought we wanted to make a stance, a change, show people that we ain't willing to get pushed over, pushed around.
Yeah. It's kind of why I was thinking.
I'd be vexed if we just give him the gold.
And this is me just being blunt. Are we scared because we know we don't have Gold Rush funding no more?
No.
Are we
no.
pushing away because it's more tea?
Scared. I don't think none of us are scared.
I don't think it'll be easy.
None of us are scared. I get if you feel like you owe him the gold because of how we're respecting, but bro,
I don't give two shits about the gold. It's never been about the money.
He can suck his mum. You know what I mean? Like, we stand our ground with this one until we can't take it.
Yeah. I wouldn't have been in this family if I actually cared about money. Because I can't lie, you guys are a money sink. That's me being blunt. But I love you guys.
Oh yeah, by the way, regardless, whatever happens to that, to the Gold Rush money, the Gold Rush money will not be ours. Even if we never give it back to him.
Yeah.
Bro, we can't do anything with the money anyway, bro. Like,
even the $5 million he's talking about.
I'm talking about the cash and everything. None of it's coming
together. Yeah, no, I don't care none of it. Yeah. Either way, bro, like the gold dust literally does absolutely nothing for us, but we don't know when we're gonna need that leverage and we'd be dense to give it back. Like, on a big
we're not giving that shit back. It doesn't matter. We're just not giving it back. I'm gonna be honest. If we give that shit back, like, he's always talking about how he's playing chess and everyone else is playing checkers. If we give that back, we're just giving him a piece.
Yeah, we're folding.
It might just be like we've made maybe some choice decisions recently, but let's not make another one.
Bro, he was the one asking for action and we're giving him action.
Exactly.
And that's when he asked me, I told him, you wanted action, so I took action. And then he said, I'll show you action. And then that's...
Let's wait for it then.
Yeah.
That's it, yeah. Ends here right now for the circle, anyway, innit? I can give him a call later. I'll tell you everything that's said. Whether it's a shit decision or a good decision, we're a gang. So we stand by it and we cover everyone's asses, you know? Don't leave no one out to dry. Shit decisions get made,
but I'm sure SK said this, but please, you got an opinion or something, like, or like, you know, if you're not in alignment with people, don't think just because your opinion doesn't match with everyone else's that you can't feel like you can't say it, you know what I mean? Like, if you've got a different opinion or you're not happy with something, like, please say it, because all that's going to do is get built up, and then, you know, a month down the line, it's all going to come out and we're just going to be doing all of this again.
Yeah. I mean, Sparky, what did I do after you shot T?
What do you mean?
What did I do? I drove you off, but then while we were in the car, what did I say? I went to go...
Yeah, you wanted to go back and call EMS or not?
Yeah, I wanted to take him back to the hospital. But when we went back there, he was already gone.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
I didn't get any backlash from Sparky from that.
No, it's not about like the backlash, it's about everyone being on the same page. You know, if everyone's secretly hiding that they feel a different way, then when it comes to it, not everyone's going to be in the right mindset, and it's just going to be bickering.
Yeah,
we did what we did.
Yeah, it wasn't us, just you, mate.
Yeah, I did what I did. I'm a standby till the day I die.
No, it's funny because I did say that to him. I said, even though, you know, it doesn't matter what the decision it is, like, you understand, like, he knows that people are standing by you because of the position you're in. Like, no, he's not dumb. He understands why he did it. I told him, I said, I respect the decision. He said, we've never done that before, though. We've never done a blood in, blood out. Why only him? And I said, because that's how SK likes to do it, and that's the new way we do it, and you were the first one, pretty much.
See, that's why I want to call him. He still doesn't understand why I did it.
No, he does. He does. He understands, he just doesn't agree with it. He did say that. He said, I understand why he did it, and I understand why people are agreeing with him. I don't agree with the decision, because he feels like he's done so much for all of us, and for you to do that to him is kind of backstabbing him. But he also understands why you did it. Like, he just said, we've never been like that. If he felt like other people... He mentioned Dean specifically. He said it didn't happen to Dean, so why him?
And Dean said, never left. He got kicked.
Yeah, that's
No,
bro. We've never been someone to leave. Like, him saying we've never been like that. We've never been like just being able to leave, bro. People don't leave the Mandem. That's never been
the
thing.
He did leave the first time, no?
Well, no, so he said...
He was talking about him getting demoted, though. Like, that's different.
He said the only reason Dean got shot is because Dean refused to hand over his vest. Regardless, it doesn't matter, you know? Things are a new way. Chin up. Crack on. If you got any problems, raise them.
Mm-hmm. And I've shot Dean myself 3 times. And 2 times of that was shooting Winston.
You're a sick bastard.
Come on. No, I'm not gonna lie. Shooting your day one is probably the worst pain you can ever carry.
I don't know, I've shot my a few times, quite funny. Right, is that me and adjourned? Because I'm going to go
throw
up in the bush if that's the case.
You throw up in the bush?
Hold on. Yeah.
Shit, are you still ill?
Yeah.
Fuck.
I really want to drag this on. Thing is, I could spice this up so much more, but I don't want to like I want to make sure I'm staying aligned with my character, because that ultimately it could be sick to, like, when I call T, leave some breadcrumbs. I hope someone does side with T. I think if it's anyone, it'll be Sane. I think, like,
I think Steve wants to go down that route, but I think Steve's aware that, like, his character doesn't really know T that much. I'm not gonna lie, it's a little bit confusing, because if I had to predict what would have happened, right, I think I would have said that the people who went with T was more the OGs, like your Patars, your Vinces, your Elses, your Moses, right? And then the newer members would have been more Mandem, like just for the chain rather than for T. But it seems to be that the people who know him more are more for the chain, and the people who know him less are more for him. So it's I'm confused. But I hope someone risks it for the RP, because I feel like at the moment, SK and Patar took a risk for the RP, but right now everyone's playing it very safe. So I hope someone takes a risk. Like, I'm leaving cracks in SK, like, to be opened, because I think it'll be better for the story and the content. Like, there's I could have gone about doing shit. Like realistically, if I just wanted to end it, I would have got elected leader. I would have had that conversation with Tommy in the subway. Because I know OOC. If I turn around to the gang and say, oh yeah, by the way, Tommy walked away, but I didn't shoot him, no one's actually going to press SK and be like, oh, you didn't stick to your word. No one would actually do that, let's be honest. But the reason that I'm doing it is because it creates way more shit and makes it way more interesting, and it's ignited T's like love for it again. I want to make sure that we can keep it going. Just low key, yeah, it don't like. It may, like, I've had to kind of change SK's morals in a sense to spice it up. Imagine I just turn around and backstab someone in the gang. Just characters don't have to be in the right. That's it, bro, Chris. That's it, exactly it. Bro, me as Louu? As Louu, bro. I am like intentionally, like with the shooting T thing and all that, it's like I'm having to intentionally make mistakes. Because it's so easy to be like the perfect gang member, innit? Because you just don't do anything wrong. But that's boring.